Yeah, just briefly on this piece of legislation, we're working with an organization called Purple Heart Homes with John Galena and Dale Beatty, both combat vets that are service-disabled veterans that were injured in combat. They started an organization. They're actually nominated by CNN, and they were here. I think many of you will remember them. And we're working with them to build and renovate homes all throughout the state. In my district, we have a Vietnam vet, a service-disabled vet that took shrapnel to the head, was never welcomed home properly. And about 6 months ago, maybe a little bit more, my office got a call that this veteran was going to become homeless, and that he actually doesn't even have a functioning shower, works at the local supermarket, and uses the local gym early in the morning for his shower. We haven't always done the right thing by our vets, and this organization is picking up that slack, a lot of good work. But the reason why we've done this and digging into, even if you have a not-for-profit that's willing to donate their time, their services, their money, or if you have individuals that are willing to donate property, even in my district, especially in my district, but in all of our districts, we know that the expense of property taxes. We had a piece of property that was going to be donated. It was going to be 10 acres of property that was going to be donated for a service-disabled vet, but the taxes on that property were over $20,000. So even if that service-disabled vet could benefit from that home being donated to them, they wouldn't be able to afford the property taxes. And when we have to realize that there are men and women that have had arms lost, legs blown off, and we may think that there's a huge payday. They're lucky if they're making $2,500, $3,000, $4,000 a month after they lost both of their legs in service to this country. So they cannot afford those property taxes. Other states, great states, not dissimilar to New York, and also a great state, but states like Texas, have allowed this exemption. This is critically important, and I hope that at some point, if not this year, soon, the Assembly will pass this bill as well. Thanks.